parasitically be working. Parasitically work, you seem not to be able to put out the air.
It's
a touchy subject, mainly because this is something that most of, which I'm not going to do. Maybe I think more than half the people who are here, they grow up without their fathers. So you can almost realize that if you talk about our country already, it's something that almost every second child is battling with. So I think this book is very appropriate and hopefully it will reach out where it's supposed to be. You, so I think the lady who spoke after the movies said your writing is like to take people on an emotional roller coaster. It's true, because the first chapter of your book, you started with one of the very heavy stories of Africa, Rwanda. For all those who don't know, between the Tutsis and... Yeah, so the ladies got raped by the other tribe and they gave children that they called them children of the snake. And you begin to ask a very fundamental question in terms of your identity. So for example, one of the things that you're raising is if my coming to be born was through somebody being raped, am I a gift from God or I am a child of the snake? Difficult subject to tell. But that's where you start. Already the emotions are high for us because we want to know. But I think it is the next chapter where you drop the bomb to almost all of us, telling us that at the age of 3, you lost your own dad. So now you hit home because you realize that, wow. So Tulane is writing about fatherhood, but yet he himself grew up without a biological father. I think what is most interesting about it is the fact that while you read that book, you begin to realize a thread. And the thread is this. While biological father, while a biological father was not present, there was another father present. It's amazing. Because you begin to see, there was actually another father present. We might not have seen it by through the naked eye, but you see him just hovering over your life until to this day. And it's amazing that for us who have been fortunate to get born again, we think that God only came to our life when we got born again. Lest we realize that He has always been there. Always been there, just, you know, maneuvering and making sure that as it is one day we're going to have a book called Father and Child. Going to my close of this presentation is there's one chapter that really blew my mind in your book, which was education system. Education system. And I think like Moses said, you are a very gentleman. Even in your writing, you could almost see that. You know, Tulane always avoids extremes in that. He's one guy who will go to another extreme, but quickly come there and balances you before you find yourself in that one extreme. So in that chapter, you sort of hit on the education system, but at the same time you appreciate the role that has played by researchers in your life. It's amazing, you know. And that is good because I think what you begin to realize is I don't think that in South Africa that the system of education that we have has an ability of taking this country to where we want to do. It's very unfortunate. That there's a lot of things that needs to change. But you know what is unfortunate to learn is that because of the outliers, not in the descriptive statistics, they talk about outliers. Because of the outliers which are here in you, who somehow have made it through the system, it is easy for people to conclude that it's working. It's not. We are really our brothers and sisters. There's hundreds of our brothers and sisters who are left behind because the system cannot be able to produce the majority who can be able to be future leaders of this country. So hopefully that chance will be that you'll be able to strike a conversation in terms of what is it that needs to change. Because it's not just about what we're learning, it's about why we're doing it. And I think that's what you get to say, I did stuff that I did not understand, where, how are they related? One of the jokes that we make in South Africa is that when we were doing our lowest grades, they made us to label transformer. Yeah? They make us to label the transformer and the frog. And to this day, I don't know the relevance of that. But that's what we got at the very end of the publication. We can't be able to link it. But let me conclude by saying this. I think a week ago, I posted a screenshot with the poster for this book launch. And I posted Jeremiah chapter 1. And it says, the Lord gave me this message from this Jeremiah. I knew you before I formed you in your mother's womb. Before you were born, I set you apart and appointed you as my prophet to the nations. Jeremiah is confused why God is choosing him. He doesn't see any relevance. He doesn't see him as qualified. He thinks it's incompetence. And all of a sudden, boom, he gets this. And I'm saying this to you, my brother, because I think you're not only my friend, my brother to me, is that you just need to continue realizing that what you are and what you continue to be and continue to write is not something that was decided now. God long decided that you're going to do these things. And I think one of the things that you are grateful as your friend is the fact that you are being faithful and committed to the cause that God has given you. And then to continue to write and read true stories. Actually, when I was reading your book, I was going to have a conversation and we need to change the title. I think I'm going to come up with a new title. Because I felt that there's something more deeper than just father and child. It's good. But I'm saying that we are so grateful as your friend for your commitment to Christ. For you being a father to us, by the way, maybe you didn't know this, that the fact that we are brothers, you are father to us, you're fathering us in many ways. And we appreciate it. But for you to continue to be faithful to the cause that Christ has given you. And have a better day. Yesterday was a better day, and we continue to appreciate your life. And you really are a role model, not just to the younger ones, speaking to us as your brothers. So we really appreciate you. Thank you very much.